It's often said that special forces men live by chance, love by choice, but kill by profession. But the regimentation within this elite, cold-blooded fighting force is unlike any other Indian Army unit. There is an official hierarchy in the system, but it seems that here it's eclipsed by a sense of equality. As part of another routine field exercise, this raid party has been ordered to destroy a simulated communication center behind enemy lines. It's a long drive across desert country, and the terrain's extreme conditions can get difficult for the men and their machines. For instance, the vehicles tend to misbehave, batteries are prone to failure, fuel, oil and coolant filters get blocked by sand and dust, and tires tend to rupture easily. As dust falls and the team closes in on the target, it's time to switch to a quieter foot patrol. Dismount and divide in groups, because stealth and guile here are now as important as speed and surprise.
Party commanders ko unka ilaka bata diya gaya hai, sabne apna ilaka dekh liya.
But before the final attack on the communications center, the young commander calls for a final briefing. He wants to quickly go over the expected rundown of the operation. Fiercely protective of one another, there is no yelling of orders, no psychofancies. First, neutralize the sentries on guard with little or no sound.
अंदर जाने के बाद तू demolition लगा देगा, ध्यान रखेगा संजय कि demolition की taping ठीक से हुई.
Simultaneously, the demolition specialist sneaks in and quickly rigs up the explosive within the base.
एक बार पहली गोली चलने के बाद कोई शक मत रखना, सीधे हमारी assault party इधर से धावा करती है.
And finally, if all goes well, everyone gets out before the explosive rips through the base. It's a simple plan, but it requires coordination, timing and speed. Most of the operations that are carried out by special forces in the deserts obviously involved vehicle mounted raids, vehicles like this.
Sir.
So do you feel that you guys are sufficiently equipped to carry out any operation deep into enemy territory of the nature that we read about in books?
Yes, sir, to a large extent. There would always be shortcomings in terms of the technology, but we like to make it up with our training, sir. I think, yes, we are definitely capable of launching any kind of operation which you people read in books that are carried out behind enemy lines.
What is the single biggest bonding factor for SAS men and special forces men?
So possibly when you see death from such close quarters, there's a camaraderie which goes up, sir.
Okay, now tell me, how old are you?
I'm 25, sir.
25. And at 25, life and death is of no consequence to you?
No, sir. Life and death is definitely of a lot of consequence to me. But I feel the training that is imparted to us makes me feel confident, sir, that whatever happens, I'm going to come back alive with my men, sir.
Honor, valor, and duty, and an oath taken in blood, is at the very essence of being a Marine commando.